What's up, internet? Today you will learn how to connect with Oracle Database Express Edition using tools like SQLPLUS and SQL Developer. So without wasting your time, let's start.
For the demonstration, I will be establishing a connection with database using SysUser. Let's do that. Connecting with the Oracle Database Express Edition using SQLPLUS is extremely easy. First, open up the command prompt. Step 2. Write SQLPLUS followed by a forward slash and then the keyword as followed by another keyword sysdb. Since sys is an external user, thus a forward slash will eradicate the need to write the username and password. You can learn more about external user in the tutorial I did a while ago. Link is on your screen and in the description as well. Anyways, that's all we have to do. On pressing enter, you will be connected with the Oracle Express Edition using SysUser. We are connected. Let's check. The user using which we are connected right now is Sys. Let's also check the container. The container through which we are presently connected is cdb$root. Next, let's connect with the Oracle Express Edition using SQL Developer. Setting up SQL Developer is extremely easy. It doesn't require any installation. This is how it's done. Go to oracle.com. /tools/downloads/sqldev-downloads.html. I will leave this link in the description. On this page, you will be presented with a list of various download options. Since I'm installing it on my Windows 10, thus I will go with the first option. To save the time, I have already downloaded the file. Here it is. Now extract these files at your desired location. You can extract them wherever you want in your file system. Again, to save time, I have already extracted them in my C drive. Now, among these extracted files, look for sqldeveloper.exe. Here it is. Double click and open it. Here we have our SQL Developer up and running. To make a connection with Oracle Database Express Edition, click on this big green plus button. This will open up a pop-up window. In this pop-up window, you have to specify your database credentials. Let's do that. Name. You can give the name of your choice to your database connection. I will name it Sys. Database type. This is going to be Oracle. Authentication type. Let it stay set on default. Username. Since I'm creating a database connection for my Sys user, thus the username is going to be Sys. Role. Since Sys user must always be a Sys DBA, thus set the role to Sys DBA. Password. Specify the password of your Sys user. Mine is Oracle. Next, click on Save Password. Connection type. Let it stay set on basic. Now, the details. For Oracle Database Express Edition, in most cases, these default host name, port number, and SID will work. You don't have to change them. Let's check if these settings work in my case or not. To check, we will press the test button. The result came out successful, which means these settings work for me. Now in case they don't, then you have to check your hostname and port number from LISTENER.ORA file. Let me show you how. But first, press the save button to save these settings. First, find out the LISTENER.ORA file. For that, open up the command prompt. Here we are. Now write LSNRCTL status. Here is the status of our listener.ora file. You can check the host name and port number from this status as well. But in case you want to check it from listener.ora file, then the parameter listener parameter file holds the location of your listener.ora file. Let's check it out. First, let me copy this location. Done. Now I will visit this location in my Explorer. Here I am at my Explorer. I will paste the location that I copied right here. Here we go. And here is our listener.ora file. You can open it and check out the desired information.
Before I sign off today, let me show you how to connect with Oracle Database Express Edition using username and password.
Two techniques that we will be using are using TNS service and using connect string. Let's start with the first one, the TNS service. First of all, if you don't know what is TNS service and how to create one, then I have done a video on it. Go ahead and watch that. Link is in the description and on the screen. That being said, let's open up the command prompt. Here we go. For the demonstration, the username that I will be using here is HR. Password for this user is also HR. And the name of the TNS service is XEPDB1. XEPDB1 is also the name of the pluggable database that has this HR user. Anyways, let's use this information to connect with the database. First, write SQLPLUS. Followed by username, which is HR. And then a forward slash. Followed by password, which is again HR. After that, add the rate sign and the name of the TNS service, which is XEPDB1 in my case. There should not be any space between the password HR and add the rate sign. Press enter and you are connected. If you don't know the TNS service name, but you know the host name, port number, and the pluggable database name which has your user, then you can use this information to connect with the database. Let me show you. Again, write SQLPLUS, followed by username HR, and then a forward slash, followed by password, which is again HR. After that, add the rate sign. So far, things are the same as the previous method. Nevertheless, do you remember? Earlier, I showed you how to find out host name and port number using listener.ora file. If you want, you can take help from there because you will need this information now. Anyways, without giving any space, write the host name and the port number separated by colon. Then put a forward slash, followed by the service name. That in my case is XEPDB1. Press enter and you are connected.
These are the different ways to connect with Oracle Database Express Edition. Hope you find this video helpful. If so, then give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.